skiff. We got some divers on scene. Boats are compartmentalized, so, and the new boats as well. It's commercial regulation, so my guess is they're trying to pump out section by section. Looks like they're trying to pump out the anchor hold right now, what we call the forecastle.
Water's not going down.
We got just as much water coming in. They're pumping out. I don't know if you can see it on camera here, but man, looking in that open window, she's just full of mud in there. Full of holes, I don't think they can pump it. Fellow thing, same thing as last time. They tried to, earlier in the footage, you see they were trying to pump on day one and day two, and it wasn't working out. At this point, they might just have to ease it up a few inches at a time and let it drain, hope it doesn't fall apart. Here, I guess they're gonna get a man under it and see what, get somebody down inside, if maybe see what's happening. I would say they might have caught 1% of the oil that came out of the
fishing down the river right now.
It has been for three weeks now. It's just a tragedy. And even when they did have the boom on, it's all just going right underneath the boom.
They have to get the
current.
They have to get the other bulwark out of the water. They're dreaming.
And all the combings, yeah. The fellow up front saying, he knows, he's saying, same thing as the last time. Standing on him.
Who said that?
I don't know, one of the foremen or something. He's like, this guy here in the green.
They have to lift it, man. And if they do,
yeah.
You get out of here.
Yeah.
You go on the bottom.
Yeah, yeah, good call. Yeah, I was going to back off as soon as this. But don't worry. success with the pump by the sound of it. Not surprising. Almost ready to go. See whatever he's gonna do. Jack above water here, you can see some leakage coming up through the bulwarks. Pump hauling ass up there, but I don't think it's doing anything. Pumps on. Again, the boat is compartmentalized, so they're trying to pump out each section to see if they get any headway. Try to lighten the load for the cranes, because you don't want to have a strap break or crush the boat, or any number of nasty things can happen. Diver in the blue hard hat there. He's putting hoses down into the fish hole. We're going to try and pump the fish hole. The other fellows on the stern here are going to try and pump out the lazarette hole. Sorry, just for the lazarette compartment. Hey, look out. Good boy. Thank you. You're okay. It's okay. You can move that hose. Now you're okay. You're good. If you're thirsty, go down and get your hose. Pumps on board now. Not having any success on that bow pump. Fellow was just saying that she's still full of water, even though we've got a pump running there for half an hour at least. That's the fish hold right there. They've got three pumps on that sucker. You got three hoses. They're trying to suck it out so they can lighten the load. Oh, this is going on while we got some serious current running here in the Fraser River. Quite a crowd of onlookers. Action down here. These guys are going to get a couple more pumps. Swinging her around a little bit here. That's quite a bit. And we're pulling. diver is signaling that the bow has been pumped out too dry, so now they're going to move the pump. That's very, very good news. Looks like they might be able to float it after all. Or at least lighten the load enough to It seems crazy to be bumping this water just onto the deck there, but it's all going out in scuppers down the side here, as you can see. So once again, they're pumping out all the holes in the watertight compartments between all the bulkheads. There are several bulkheads in the boat that are theoretically watertight. A whole boat like this, that's highly unlikely. Tough bunch of guys, man. Priming another pump here, pouring some water into it to get her pump primed up. And we have five pumps on the aft deck now. Still one going on the fore deck there, I guess. Maybe two. Starting to see the water line on the hull here, so they've got it up far enough to theoretically float if they can get enough water out of it. Travel lift is standing ready there, ready to haul her up if they can manage to get it into the slip and get the slings on it. As I say, you can actually see the water line on the hull here. Massive cranes on the barges. up pretty good. Keep our fingers crossed. The last few drops of muddy water coming out there. Looks like I spoke a little too soon. They repositioned the pump down there and getting some more water out. The captain going down into the fish hole to check things out, I guess. Reposition some hoses. But again, this is, they're getting the water out of it. That's really important. Big boss, any helmet here, any hard hat. Oh, diver's getting in the water over there. Just washing off his suit. Okay, we've got the fore deck, the bow line's being cast off here, so. Let's see if we can get a focus on that. Bow line has been cast off and she's, they're floating her up against the barges here. Like we're getting ready to see if she floats. Diver is finished rinsing off. Crane operator tooting his horn there. Heavily supported by the slings that I, my gut says she's floating. Let's see all the rotten planks and things. That's why she went down.